Hi everyone, I welcome you all in the second lecture of Diabetes Mellitus series. Myself Dr. Chagan Kharthode, physician in diabetologist in Vishwaraj Hospital. I'm going to talk about types of diabetes mellitus today. So diabetes mellitus is broadly divided, classified into two main categories on the basis of pathogenic process leading to hyperglycemia. And the two broad categories are type 1 diabetes mellitus and type 2 diabetes mellitus. There is increasing recognition of other form of diabetes mellitus in which molecular pathogenesis is better understood and may be associated with single gene defect. And that form of diabetes mellitus shares clinical features of either type 1 or type 2 or maybe sometimes both. Move on to type 1 diabetes mellitus. Type 1 diabetes mellitus are results of autoimmunity against insulin producing beta cells. There is interaction between genetic, environmental, and immunological factor ultimately lead to immune-mediated destruction of pancreatic beta cells and resulting in complete or near total insulin deficiency. Usually type 1 diabetes mellitus can develop at any age, but most commonly before 20 years of age. And also there is evidence that not all patients of type 1 diabetes mellitus has evidence of autoimmunity. Goes on pathogenesis. In susceptible individual, the autoimmune process is triggered by some infectious and environmental stimulus leads to autoantibody against beta cells. And there is a progressive loss of insulin secretion. Usually features of this diabetes doesn't evident until the threshold loss of insulin secretions or beta cell mass occurs. My studies, that autopsy study suggests that degree of loss of beta cell mass is variable at time of the disease presentation, but may be high as high as 70 to 80%. This is a subtype. This is latent autoimmune diabetes mellitus in adults. This is a subtype of type 1 diabetes mellitus. This is characterized by presence of autoantibodies, cell-mediated immune response, and impairment in beta cell function. But usually, this is slower than classical type 1 diabetes mellitus. Criteria, which is given by Immunology of Diabetes Society, adult onset more than 30 years, and presence of any beta cell antibodies and absence of insulin requirement at least 6 months after the diagnosis. As type 1 diabetes mellitus is very less common, approximately 5 to 10% of diabetes have type 1 diabetes. Currently, actually, there is no one know how to prevent diabetes, but generally is managed well by living a healthy lifestyle, managing blood sugar and getting regular health checkups. Type 2 diabetes mellitus, it is characterized by insulin resistance, impaired insulin secretion, excessive hepatic glucose production, abnormal fat metabolism, and systemic low-grade inflammation. And obesity is, particularly visceral obesity, is very common in type 2 diabetes mellitus. Risk factors of type 2 diabetes mellitus, there is family history, physical inactivity, overweight, BMI of more than 25. In Indian, BMI of more than 23 is considered as overweight. Previously identified impaired fasting glucose or impaired glucose tolerance and intolerance. HbA1c of more than 5.7 to 6.4. History of GDM, hypertension, its blood pressure is more than 140/90. HDL cholesterol of more than 35 or triglyceride more than 250, polycystic ovarian disease and history of cardiovascular disease are high risk factor for the type 2 diabetes mellitus. Pathogenesis, in this high risk population, there is an insulin resistance. And in background of insulin resistance, there is an increased insulin production from beta cells to control the glucose tolerance. As insulin resistance increase and compensatory hyperinsulinemia progress, later on beta cell get tired and they are unable to sustain hyperinsulinemic state, and which lead to impaired glucose tolerance. and that is characterized by elevation of postprandial glucose. Further decline in insulin secretion and increased hepatic glucose production lead to over diabetes and fasting hyperglycemia. When that beta cell fails and insulin secretion comes down, there is insulin suppression of glucagon decreases and there is glucagon production is increased, and that leads to hepatic glucose overproduction, and overall that's overall hyperglycemia. In this high risk for people, we need screening to have diabetes mellitus or pre-diabetes. Fasting plasma glucose or HbA1c has been used for screening of this high risk group, and is recommended by WHO because the large number of individuals who meets criteria for diabetes mellitus are asymptomatic and they are unaware about they have disease. And some studies suggest that type 2 diabetes mellitus may be present up to decade before the diagnosis. Some individuals with type 2 diabetes mellitus have one or more diabetes specific complication at the time of diagnosis. Fourth thing is treatment of the type 2 diabetes favorably altered the natural history of diabetes mellitus, and diagnosis of pre-diabetes with the help of a lifestyle modification may help to prevent diabetes mellitus. So EDA recommends the screening of all individuals above 45 years every third yearly, and screening of individual at earlier age if they have overweight or some more additional risk factor of diabetes, that also every third yearly. Features of current classification of diabetes mellitus merits emphasis from the previous. First thing is we used to call NIDDM previously type 1 diabetes mellitus, and NIDDM for type 2 diabetes mellitus and IDDM for type 1 diabetes mellitus, they are no longer used, because individually type 2 diabetes mellitus eventually require insulin for better control of sugar. Second thing, age or a treatment modality is not a criterion, because type 1 diabetes mellitus most commonly develops before 20 to 30, but autoimmunity can develop at any age. Even type 2 diabetes mellitus also typically develops with increasing age, but nowadays they are being diagnosed more frequently in children and young adult, particularly in obese adolescent. Next subtype is gestational diabetes mellitus. See, glucose intolerance developing during second and third trimester is classified as gestational diabetes mellitus. During pregnancy, there is changes in metabolic changes which lead to insulin resistance, and that leads to increased insulin demands, may lead to impaired glucose tolerance and diabetes. As incidence, there is a 1 in 7 patient in worldwide as affected by GDM or pre-existing diabetes. Most women with diabetes mellitus revert to normal glucose in postpartum, but there is substantial risk of developing diabetes mellitus in next 20 to 30 year. In addition, the children born to the mother of GDM also have increased risk of developing metabolic syndrome and type 2 diabetes mellitus later in the life. So EDA recommends the woman with history of GDM should undergo lifelong screening for development of diabetes and pre-diabetes at least every 3 yearly. Other specific types of diabetes mellitus. First one is genetic defect. In this case, there is a genetic defect in insulin secretions or action, some mitochondrial abnormalities, maybe some genetic defect in insulin receptor, which lead to impaired glucose tolerance. There are some genetic defect, that is hepatocyte nuclear transcription factor 4 alpha, that called maturity onset diabetes of young type 1. Glucokinase, that maturity onset diabetes of young type 2. Hepatocyte nuclear transcription factor 1 alpha, that called maturity onset diabetes of young type 3. There are others also, insulin promoter factor 1, hepatocyte nuclear transcription factor 1 beta, Nero D1, insulin and subunit of ATP sensitive potassium channel leading to permanent neonatal diabetes. Next one is, this is a maturity onset diabetes of young. This is autosomal dominant inheritance. The early onset of hyperglycemia usually before 25 years of age. and there is impaired insulin secretion. This is of exocrine pancreas. Here is the primary pathology originating from pancreas exocrine tissue, which lead to destruction of pancreatic beta cells and leads to hyperglycemia because of insulin deficiency. That examples are cystic fibrosis, chronic pancreatitis, and hemochromatosis. Next one, endocrinopathies. The growth hormones and steroids are actually antagonists for insulin action. So the endocrine problem where these hormones, excessive hormone secretes then antagonize the insulin action that lead to diabetes mellitus. These are acromegaly, Cushing syndrome, glaucoma, pheochromocytoma, hyperthyroidism, and aldosteronism. Drug-induced, excessive use of steroid, Vecor, rodenticide, pentamidine, nicotinic acid, diazoxide, beta-adrenergic agonist, thiazides. These are the drugs can lead to hyperglycemia and ultimately diabetes mellitus. Infection, there is very rare causes, but some infection like congenital rubella, cytomegalovirus, and coccidiovirus can lead to the pancreatic cell destruction and diabetes mellitus. This is a rare form of diabetes mellitus, termed as fulminant diabetes, has been noted in Japan, may be related to viral infection of this isolate.